we just left the parking lot, and now we're driving to Ridger Sport, and we kind of have a optimal view screen, which shows us our estimated time of arrival and our distance. What we have here is one screen setting, which is 3D with the next maneuver, and tells me exactly when I'm going to make that. I have the speed limit presented, but what's interesting about this is I get automatic updates when there's something like traffic in front of me. I can one touch to get rid of that. But you'll notice that when I pick up speed at a certain threshold, the camera actually zooms up.
Yep.
So this is really there for when you're driving on a highway or, you know, on a side street. You need a different perspective based on your speed and the contextual area around you. So now we're at the red light here, and as I slow down, it'll actually zoom in to everything around
me. Okay. And that's really what's different, because I was going to ask you, well, what is different from a normal nav system that you're seeing today? And so that's one of the things, that it adjusts the view based on your speed and your direction of travel.
Yes. But this is just one application setting, so I can do, maybe I like to have my list of maneuvers. That's there. Let me go back to the 3D screen. What's also interesting is if I touch this, I can actually share this information via SMS or email to my friends, my colleagues. This was actually implemented for driver safety. Because if you think, everyone kind of uses their smartphone while they're driving to text people, you know, update them. When are you going to be there? We found out with this application, you diminish the number of interactions if you use it safely and correctly by like 70%.
So you can do a voice-controlled SMS to tell your friend when you're going to arrive where you're going?
Right now it's not voice enabled, but obviously that's the trajectory. For demo purposes, we, you know, you put in a phone number or an email address, or...
But is it linked to your directory in your phone, basically? So if it was linked, you'd see the list of people to choose from.
Exactly.
Okay.
So then you can alert them to let you know when you're going to be there, and they can also see, you know, is the person stuck in traffic and where they are at their current location. Now, I will say this is just a reference application. So if a customer said, you know what, we just want you to send the ETA as just a time,
right,
that's what we would implement.
So if you sent the ETA and then the traffic changed, and so the navigation updated with your new time, does it automatically send a new ETA?
Not
if you've sent that SMS? But you can tell it to. Okay.
There's software thresholds of only send it when it's a 5-minute change, because you don't want like 30
right,
seconds.
Every 30 seconds, exactly. Right.
But what I would like to just show you is what we've also tried to do in Hear Auto is how do the different screens interact with each other. So you can imagine that in the vehicle, maybe this might be playing music or receiving phone calls, etc. So what you need is your guidance experience in the cluster display.
Right.
So what I can hear have here is just some arrows, which is telling me what to do next. But I can easily switch and actually get now the map in my cluster.
Okay.
And I get the guidance display. So hands are on the wheel. This is playing music. I can actually just glance down and keep my eyes on the road. Because that's one thing that we do a lot of is usability testing. And for NHTSA guidelines and other guidelines, you really have to do glanceability test of how can a driver collect the information, process it, and still be safe on the road. So we just presented a couple options, you know, just regular, what my next maneuver is, the street I'm on, as well as kind of like the full guidance experience with the map.
Okay, so let's talk a little bit about the use of big data between the cloud and the vehicle, and then how data updates are done within the vehicle. whichever you want to start with first.
Yeah, sure. So that's a really important topic as we get into the subject of highly autonomous driving, because you really don't have time if you're a trailing vehicle to get a warning after it goes all the way up to the cloud. You really need that computing to happen on the edge with really low latencies. So, you know, basically in the milliseconds where, for example, if I'm upcoming to this bridge and it's icy and I'm the trailing vehicle, I need to know that instantly, because at 40, 50 miles an hour, I'm already on that bridge and have created an accident. So this is something that we're partnering both with NSN as well as a couple OEMs to try to bring this technology to life in real-world demonstrations.
Okay, great. And then updating the data in the car, can we talk about that a little bit too? Coming back to...
Yeah, so we know one of the biggest
interface. Yep.
Pain points for consumers today is actually getting an updated map in their vehicle, because typically content is probably 2 to 3 years old when they first get into the vehicle. So what Here Auto does, it offers the ability to get over-the-air updates. And for larger regions such as Germany, we can actually break that down into a specific region. Because when you're really driving in just Berlin, 90% of the time, you don't need all of Germany updated. You just need specific areas of that country or that region updated. So you can have that map fresh in your vehicle. And then when you go outside that zone, you can choose to update your map with all of Europe, all of Germany, all of France, things like this. And that's really available via connectivity and the software application of Here Auto.
Okay, so we're getting close to chocolate, so I guess we need to find a parking spot now.
Yeah, we do. And what's great, Here Auto offers within one touch to get parking nearby my location. So it offers parking houses that are very specific to my vehicle, my settings, and now with one touch, I can actually get directions to the park house. So we can go there and then park and be able to walk to Ritter Sport.
So when you talk about parking settings to your vehicle and your settings, what are those settings and how do you set them?
So if it's known and you have sensors, obviously we're in a pretty large vehicle here. I'm not going to be routing to a parking garage with a low entrance. As we move further, and what you'll see in the coming months is actually being able to make a reservation and trying to get pricing in payment. So you really can do all those within one or two touches once you have all those settings set. And we really like to distinguish not between the smartphone, tablet, and the in-vehicle system, because it's all based on one profile. So once you set it anywhere, as soon as it's loaded to the cloud and back down, those settings are set for you.
And those profiles, so if multiple people share a car,
yes.
I assume there can be multiple profiles. And how does it know which one of you it is?
So you can set multiple profiles, and that's really determined by the OEM, but we work with them in enabling technologies. I've seen everything from the key fob determining that it's this person getting into the vehicle, to the seat setting, to also the Bluetooth from a certain smartphone. So there are different ways to tell who the user is, and those are just a few examples.
Okay. Okay, so we've arrived and we've parked, but now we still have a little bit to walk. So what happens next?
We do. Now we're going to turn off the vehicle. So going to simulate that, shutting down, closing the application. But what's happening is we're automatically syncing our location to the cloud so we can get back to it when we need to. And what's happened is now I switch to my smartphone. So what's going to happen is I have my current location right here, and then we're going to get our destination, which we see is Ritter Sport.
Yep.
And I can set that as a destination. I see that it's pretty close, so we can walk to that.
Okay.
So as we're getting close to our destination, we saw parking pop up, and what I also see is the actual street level imagery of my final destination, so I can visually see it and be aware of what my surroundings are. And as we see, that's the Ritter Sport, the front of the store, so I definitely know exactly where we're going.
Okay.
So now I get different options on how to get back or how to arrive to the chocolate store. So you can see that it's walking only because we're pretty close, but in theory, I could also take a train or use multimodal transit. So I click on walking directions, getting my route, and let's show it. Would you like to be routed to your final destination? Of course. So it's calculating the route from where we're currently parked to the final destination, mm-hmm. and then it's going to start the guidance. What's my next turn? Mm-hmm. Go underground walkway, take a right, and then finally arrive at our destination.
Yeah, so that's great that you don't have to enter it multiple times. You enter it once, and then you can access it everywhere.
Exactly. And then actually when I'm done and I cancel this, so I'm ending my route, what's even better is after I finish, always on the home screen, I have where I am, and then within one touch, where is my vehicle?
Mm-hmm.
So we finish, maybe we go somewhere else, but we can always route back to mm-hmm. our vehicle. So this is really seamless across all screens. It's mm-hmm. your pre-trip planning, your in-vehicle navigation, and your last mile guidance all rolled into one as Here Auto.
So once you enter a destination and use it, and then you park, does the cloud know where you've parked? So could you also use it if you forget where you park?
Exactly. That's yep. The use case here, always within one touch of mm-hmm. where my vehicle is.
Mm-hmm.
And you can imagine sharing this between multiple people. Yep. Maybe you parked it on the street. And as long as that account is linked, mm-hmm. you can route back to your vehicle.
Okay.